All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And today I'm again delighted to have Anuradha ji with us here on Exotic Astrology. Welcome, madam. Nice to see you again. And today she's going to talk on a topic which is not much touched, and there's not much material also available in YouTube and in the internet. The topic is importance of deities in astrology, as we know how the divine signs of astrology is connected to the gods and how the deities will impact us in our life. Okay, so today she's going to talk about that. And tomorrow, which is 24 June, she also is starting a course on nakshatras, and the details of that course will be there in the description. All right, so the stage is all yours. Please tell us what you're going to share.
Thank you so much, Babajit, for giving me this platform to share something very beautiful and very close to my heart, and that is the deities. The deities are associated with astrology. That we all know. Because when we are giving a remedial measure, the first thing we do is tell a person that worship this god or goddess. Now, the deities are also associated with the Vedas. Astrology is called a Vedang not for any other reason, but because it is so because it is so connected with the Vedas. And you know, when you study the scriptures, and I know that you do study the scriptures a lot, you would realize that there's so many features of each and every devata, god or goddesses. Say you take up Devi Durga Devi, so then are there so many features associated of being a powerful being, motherly, yet somebody who can be very ferocious, who's unafraid, fearless. Okay, so that comes into our mind automatically. And when we associate her with a particular tithi or a vara or a planet, then we know what kind of powers the person will have, what kind of latent habits or characteristics a person can have, and what the person can evolve as. There are many. So, and it's not just the nakshatras that are associated with the deities. Before, nakshatra is again a part of the panchang. So the panchang is the basis of our natal chart. Even before you construct the natal chart, you are asked, it gives you a certain detail as to which day you are born, which tithi you are born, which under which nakshatra you are born, which yoga and which karana is operating at the date of your, on the day of your birth. So all of these have a resonance in the deity associated with it. Everything has a deity associated with it. And then when we move forward, the planets that you talk about in the Rasi chart. You say sun, so you worship the sun god. Okay, agreed. But you know that Shiva is associated with sun god. When you say moon, the goddess associated with moon is Parvati. So when somebody is born on a Monday, I can say that the person is very calming, has a very calming and a loving effect on anybody. And that person is also can be very bold if there is a need. Can is very family oriented. Will love to feed people. So all these things, if somebody is born on a Wednesday, so you can say that the person is very quick in the mind. Ganesh ji is very quick in the mind. Lord Vishnu has got a super mind. Provided the Mercury in the chart is not afflicted.
Okay.
Okay. Then somebody born on Chaturthi, the fourth, the fourth distance between the moon and the sun. So that person again is ruled by the deity again of Chaturthi is Ganesha. So that person will have the ability to remove obstacles, find way through obstacles. Will have a very sharp mind. Will be fond of eating. Okay, and will be a favorite with so many people, can lead people. So all these things, how you cannot memorize it. You cannot memorize these things. You need to have certain associations with the devis and the devtas and the gods and the goddesses. And one of the best things is to read the Bhagavad Purana. I mean, before people ask that, how do we know about them? You should read the Bhagavad Purana. Because it's not possible for us to read the Vedas. The very, very challenging for the layman today, because we do not know that kind of Sanskrit. So if there is a scholar who's able to teach you, then there's nothing like it. If you can take those Sanskrit classes, but reading the Bhagavad Purana, because it shows the Dasha Avatars of Vishnu. Apart from that, it has detailed, prescriptions, or it has detailed views about each and every gods, goddesses, and everybody, and the devis and the devtas. So let's move ahead with, let me share my screen and tell you how it is all about. I firmly believe that the devtas are a coded answer for us in astrology. The moment we are able to understand an inherent quality of a devata associated with a particular nakshatra, with a particular var, with a particular, that is, day, with a particular tithi, with a particular divisional chart, we will be able to read that with so much precision. So let me take you just through the presentation. The tithi here, if the tithi is, as I said, with the pratipada or the 16, what is the pratipada? Pratipada means it's the when the sun is with the moon, that is on Amavasya, right after Amavasya, when the moon moves 12 degrees away from the sun. So they make a distance. That mathematical distance is termed as pratipada or ekam. Then we have the dvitiya. Then another 12 degrees is the dvitiya. Now there is an association of a deity with it. So the first, and again, when once it reaches the purnima or the full moon, then again, that is exactly diametrically 180 degree opposite the sun when moon reaches 180 degree opposite the sun, because the moon travels much more faster than the sun. The moon travels, in 128 days, it travels the entire zodiac, whereas the sun travels only one house, one sign in 30 days. So the moon is traveling around 13 times faster than the sun. So when the moon is 180 degrees apart from the sun, then it is called the Purnima. And when it is 180 plus 12 degrees, it completes one day, which is known as Pratipada. Again, that's the 16th day of the Masam or the month. So it's ruled by Agni. Okay, so such a person might show hunger, such a person might show ability to transform things. Such a person might have the courage to do things, because Agni consumes. So again, that's why I said hunger. Then also the person may be able to be a good communicator between two people, because the Agni, what does it do? It takes from us, especially the Vedi Agni, the Agni of the Vedas, it takes the ahuti or the offering or the oblation that we give into the pride. It takes it from us and it transports it to the gods and the goddesses. Okay, and that's seven tongues. So the person can actually be a fairy tongue also. And this Agni goes beyond control. It can show jealousy also. Somebody born on Ashtami, that is ruled by Shiva. So this person will go out of his way to help others.
Okay.
will not be afraid to take pains for others. See, Shiva was the one who took in the halahal. And he didn't do it for himself. He would, that person would show a lot of, love and affection for people who are below him in status. He would be able to accept everyone and anyone. That is what Ashtami does to you. Okay. And then you have Ekadashi. So the Vishwa Devatas. Today is Ekadashi. So we are by default, we are pleasing the Vishwa Devatas by sacrificing our food. We are pleasing them. We are offering. And when you keep a fast, there's a very important reason when you keep a fast. You are suffering, you are sacrificing certain, not just your food, but you also need to sacrifice your ego, your anger. If you get angry on this day, a lot of your merit is lost. Okay, so it's getting a control over your six, Shadripi. And people can say that, I am being philosophical, but if you go to the Puranas, you will see that there is an association. And I'll show you charts where you will be able to see the association. Mm-hmm. And then when I'm taking in again, Purnima. On Purnima, it's the moon which is associated. It's in its full glory. So anybody who is born on Purnima will have the association like of the moon. Beautiful. However, fickle-minded. Because the moon keeps waxing and waning. Can also get emancipated at some time, okay? And that person can also show certain, licentious behavior, because the moon had so many wives, and it also ability of favoritism. Because he had a wife whom he was very partial to, Rohini. Such a person can also be suffering from certain curses. It's not that every person who is associated, all of us will be doing that. No, but there has to be something else resonating in your chart to cement that fact, or something on the counter resonating in your chart to diminish this fact.
Yeah, and one thing I wanted to ask you here, they say that the Krishna Chaturdashi is a cursed tithi.
Yes. Yes, it is a cursed tithi. It's a very interesting story behind that, because, and do you know that Samyukta Jewel, that Krishna was Satyabhama's father, had the Samyukta Jewel, and that jewel gave 10 coins, golden coins, I think, I do not know, 100 or 10 or 1000, I do not remember how many, but I think more than 10, 100 or 1000 it gave coins, golden coins every day. So Shri Krishna went up to his to Satyabhama's father and said that, why do you not donate this to the the royal chamber, royal treasury? And he said, why? I have worshipped the sun god and I have got it as a gift from the sun god. Why should I give it to the royal treasury? It is mine. And then it got stolen. Okay, because his brother took it and went to the forest and he died, and a lot of things happened as a result of which all the blame came on Krishna, that he had stolen it from Satyabhama's uncle and killed her uncle in the process. Now they say this was because Krishna saw the this Chaturdashi, your Chaturdashi Chandrama or moon. The Chaturdashi you just mentioned
Krishna Chaturdashi.
Krishna Chaturdashi. So it was because of that. It is of the particular of a particular month, that you should not see the Chandrama. It is because what happens is during that day, that was also the Chaturdashi said to be Lord Ganesha's birthday. Okay, so he had just had, his mother had cooked a very beautiful dinner, and he was coming back, going back somewhere, and because he sits on a very, he's a huge kind of a, you know, a very roly-poly kind of a god, devata, and he's sitting on a small, again, roly-poly vehicle, that is the mouse, the musha. So when he's going, and they both are trotting, so that makes a very cute but a funny scene, and Chandrama sees and laughs. So that is the moon god. So then Ganesha says that what is there to laugh on it? And then they continue. And then what happens is Chandrama is following them. Now, because of consuming so much, Ganeshji has put on a lot of weight. Okay. And the Mushak is also, because even he has consumed, so even he's on a slow speed. All of a sudden, there's a stone on the road, and the Mushak, he kind of gives a break, and Ganeshji falls down. So this sets the Chandrama to start laughing.
Oh.
And then, you know what Ganesha does? He takes out his tusk, throws it to the moon, and says that may you start shrinking, never to be seen. If you make fun of people like that, you will understand what it is to be, you know, lose your body and things like that. And may whoever see you on this day, may the person be cursed.
Oh, on Krishna Chaturdashi?
Yes.
Ah.
So that is why there is an association.
Yeah, and it is also said, I'm not very sure of this, but it is said that on Krishna Chaturdashi, he had kidnapped Tara. I don't know. And on Amavasya, he had impregnated, and Pratipad, Mercury was born. Something like, I'm not very sure.
So you know, there's, like you just said, so there's so much information available within the coded system of the deities, of the devtas, of the gods, that if you sit to analyze a chart just on the basis of the devatas, you will find that there's so many things falling into place.
So that, so when we move on, we need to go to tithis and all. And as it said, na, Panchang tells us the direction where to look in the chart. Otherwise, sometimes you may,
yes,
have the same chart after 24 hours. Maybe the nakshatra is different, but it's totally different story because the day is different. The flow, you're looking in a different direction altogether.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now you have the yogas and the devatas. Okay. So, supposing you have this yoga of Atigandha, which is at the time of your birth, if you have Sukarma as a yoga, which is the seventh yoga. Okay. When we are taking just in by this table, given table, then Indra is the ruling deity for it. So that person will have, you know, very competitive parts, may be covered from inside, but very competitive, very jealous, always wants to be on the throne. Can be addictive.
Typical Indra traits will be there.
Yes. Then the Indra traits will be there. If somebody is born in the Shiva yoga, I'm not talking about the god Shiva, I'm talking about Shiva,
yes,
yoga. Then that person will have the qualities of Mitra. And we've worked on a nakshatra before. So we've explored the qualities of Mitra: friendly, polite, arbitrator, good lawyer, person who can communicate as well as get two opposing parties onto the same platform to get the work done, a leader.
And just for information, I'm saying yoga is also one of the panchangas.
Yeah. And then we have, supposing you are, you have it in, if somebody is born in the Brahma yoga, then that person will have the qualities of Ashwini Kumaras. Well, I do have a course on yoga, on, you know, the panchang also ready, but tomorrow the launch is of only nakshatra, where I am doing nakshatras in detail.
Yeah, even the last time when I had done a session with Nitinji, even he was showing me one chart that if there's a combination of one tithi and one day, for example, Thursday and Dashami, for example, then it's something like Jaya. It's known as Jaya. So anything you do,
yes,
that day, you'll be victorious.
Yeah, so it's you have the tithis are divided into five parts. You know, they are termed as Rikta, Nanda, Puna, and you know, Jaya, like that. So accordingly, so if somebody is, if you follow that order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that way you will know whether it's a Rikta Tithi or it's a Puna Tithi or it's a Jaya Tithi, what its effects will be. Again, who rules it? But that's a matter of Panchang. So I am, you know, it's a much, much vast field. Here we're narrowing down parts of Panchang, right? So let's move into the divisional charts also. Now, people can say that, is it associated only with the Panchang? Because Nakshatra definitely is part of only the Panchang, is a part of the Panchang. Yoga, Karna, Tithi, Vara, and Nakshatra, five parts of the Panchang. So is it that? No. The deities have their resonance everywhere. Everywhere. Test it on your charts. Now the deities of D3, and I've done that. I've taught this, you know, the divisional charts also. So I know that the deities of D3, so if they, how do you make the D3? You have to divide it into three parts of 10 degree each. And then place the planets accordingly in 1, 5, 9 from itself. Okay, so if it's that means it will fall in the same element. So if it's in the first 10 degrees, then the name is Karma, and the deity associated with it is Narada. 10 degree to 20 degree, the name is Bhog, and the deity associated with is Agastya. Now, Agastya, Narad, and Dhruvasa, they're all rishis of repute. Okay. But these rishis have their own qualities. Narad Rishi most would know that he has one aim. He follows Lord Vishnu blindly. But at times he can have a little ego. But though he is a follower of Vishnu, who is not very liked by the Rakshasas or the Daityas or the Danavs, but Narad somehow has a good reputation with everybody. So it's kind of like a journalist.
Yeah, even in 10th canto Bhagavatam it is mentioned, when he goes to Kamsa, who was killed by Krishna, Kamsa says, "Oh, great sage, you have come. Please come and sit and enlighten me."
Not just that, he also went to Bali Raja.
Yes.
So when they want work done from the, the Daityas, they push Narad Rishi in front. That first you go and, clear the field and then we'll follow. So you see, he's a great communicator. He's a great devotee. And he's devoted to the righteous causes. He knows how to, he knows how to talk. And he has great arbitration powers. So people say, I'll give you a story of Narad. Okay, so people say that if they want to, get some work, they want to come to a solution, they want to go to Narad. So Lakshmi ji and Shani Dev were very much into one fight. Who has a better gate? Who works in a better manner? Now, they went to many people, and do you think anybody can decide who walks in a better gate, Lakshmiji or Shanidev? If you, by any chance, say it's Shanidev, Lakshmiji will never grace your home ever again. And if you say Lakshmiji, Shanidev will make his presence felt in ways unknown to you.
He'll simply aspect you.
And then you will have a good say, okay? So, nobody wanted to answer that. So, Lord Vishnu says, there's one person who can really answer you. Please go to Narad. So, they go to Narad. Okay? And what does Narad do? Naradji says, okay, both of you, Naradji is like Narayan, why have you sent them here to me? But then he says, okay, now I have to build. He says, okay, if you don't mind, please, all of you, can you walk up and down the path for 5 minutes? So they do that. And they say, now you'd say. So Naraji just folds his hands and says that this is my perception. You can do whatever the ability to accept or not accept the decision is on you. So he says, you know, Shanidev, Ma Lakshmi, you look good when you're coming. And Shanidev, you look good when you're walking away. So he has such a beautiful way of portraying things that he's not angered anybody. They both bless him and go. So he's so diplomatic. And he has the veena in his hand. So he says, Narayan, Narayan.
Yeah, so maybe we can use this in a way. You know, suppose somebody's 10th lord is placed between 0 to 10 degrees. Then if we have 10 people to send somebody for negotiation, maybe you can send this person, or if somebody's moon or lagna lord is placed.
Absolutely. In the 10th house, if you have a planet, okay, the lagna lord placed in the 10th house within 0 to 10 degree, You know that this person by birth will have the ability to negotiate properly with anybody.
Oh, okay. Or whichever house it is related to that house, that planet will give the flavors.
That absolutely.
Fantastic.
So if in your third house, okay, you have a planet between 10 to 20 degrees, which is relating to the deity of Agastya. So your siblings could have hardworking abilities. They could be very intelligent. They have the ability to destroy the enemies. Very strong determination. Agastya Rishi was, if you know, and I'm sure you do, Babaji, he was the one who was requested by the Devtas to cross over Vindhyachal and to, you know, settle in the south, because Vindhyachal was growing beyond measure. Because there was a competition between Vindhyachal Parvat and sun, like as in the sun that you see. So the sun was having a problem in its path. So Agastya Rishi was asked, because the Vindhyachal worshipped Agastya Rishi was asked to move down south and never to return. He moved down south and he told the Vindhyachal, stop growing now, let me cross when I come back, because it is going to be very tedious for me to cross so much. So after I come back, only then you start growing, and it has not grown till now. So he sacrificed his own merit, his own, you know, homeland for others. There are a lot of things that you can learn, and you will see, say, your siblings will have that ability. Or you will make your communication in such a way, because it's the third house, the planet is sitting right there. So you can have the ability to be, you know, very determined in your courageous, in your whatever task. Say it's Venus which is sitting there in your third house and in between the 10 to 20 degrees. Then you know what you would be very beautifully, you know how to control. It's like having a glove in a kid's glove, in an iron hand in a kid's glove. You know how to control yourself. You know how to modulate yourself. You know how to work through your enemies in a very polite and in a very polished manner. Then we move on to Dhruvasa Rishi. He's aggressive, hot-tempered. He's known to give curses. He projects a very egoistic personality. He was the one who kicked, you know, Lord Vishnu on his chest.
That was
Dhruvasa. No, Bhrigu Rishi, but Dhruvasa Rishi. So Dhruvasa Rishi gave shrap to one of on an Ekadashi, to one of King Ambarish, who was the, you know, very loved bhakta of, you know, devotee of Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu had to come to his rescue. The Sudarshan Chakra episode happened.
Yes.
And Dhruvasa, so these people also face a lot of issues in life. There's a planet there, because of your hot-temperedness, that planet will suffer.
Okay, so we can say, maybe suppose somebody has that seventh lord placed there, then we may say that keep your anger below or else your spouse will leave you.
Or you might have to face defeat, shame.
Ah.
You might lose your merit on account of that.
Okay.
So you see, just by, and you and me are doing this on a very, you know, just discussing it on a very normal basis.
Yes.
So you can, just by knowing about the Rishi, you can get so much out of just a placement of a planet. So now.
And this is like very simple. Just check 0 to 10, then this, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, like this.
Yes.
No complications.
Now when we're doing the Navamsha, in the Navamsha, if you have a planet placed in the in a movable Navamsha, then it's ruled by the Devgat. Now if it's moved, if it's placed in the, you know, if it's placed in the, what do you mean by Devgat? The qualities would be very stellar, very, 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 you know, supposing Jupiter is placed in your Navamsha in a movable sign. So it makes you more traditional. It makes you more, not orthodox, but somebody who will follow the tried and the tested path, who would like to stay on the truth, and people who would like to go and help others, people who have good, very many good qualities. And if you have the Manushya, so which is a fixed sign, so that you have a tendency to be both the Rakshasas and the Manushyas. You would like to experiment also, but you would like to be on the fixed, on the traditional path also. Taking the best of the two, you would believe in barter system. You have the business kind of aptitude in you. The Rakshasas. Now, you can take the Rakshasas as the negative, but I take it on a person where they are not afraid of anything. The dual signs. It's a transiting sign. They are not afraid of anything. They break the ceilings and the barriers. Whatever it is. Okay. So, if there's somebody who is, say, born in a Gemini Nakshatra, I'll tell you people who have broken the barriers. Steve Jobs. Then I'm not very sure about Steve Jobs, but Bill Gates has a Gemini Nakshatra. Steven Spielberg has a Gemini Nakshatra. Yeah, Gemini Lagna. These people.
Yes.
It's a dual sign. So they have broken barriers. They have got the world of technology or the world of movies into a different level altogether.
Okay, so you are saying this this ascendant should be in the Navamsha, or because Bill Gates has Gemini Lagna in the D1, I guess?
Oh, it has a Gemini.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this will hold true for planets also? I mean, if Venus is supposed
to... Yes. So, if you take it to the Navamsha, okay, now I'm sorry I got confused with the Lagna poet. If you take it to the Navamsha, if you have that in the Navamsha, if you have one of the dual signs operating in the Navamsha, then trust me, the Lagna is, then you have the ability to break through the barriers.
Uh-huh.
You have the ability not to be afraid of anything, fearless. But it could also turn into greed and craving.
Uh-huh.
If it is afflicted, so you need to be sure of it, and yeah, that could also be ruthless.
That the whole chart will tell what's happening.
Yes. Now let's move on to the specific nakshatra deities. Okay, then the 33 forces. Okay. Operating, they say that we have 33 crore devis and devatas. Okay. But initially, as per the Rig Veda, there are 33 divine forces. We have Aditi. Who's Aditi? Aditi is mother goddess. Okay. And she's said to be the generator of all the other gods and goddesses, but at the same time, she has generated, she is also from a god. So it's a very, it's like very mixed, intermixed, interlinked. As we know, we do not know what is the starting of creation. But she, Aditi, is said to be the goddess of all the devatas and the 12 Adityas in particular. So if in the olden days, the son or the daughter was, the son in particular was also known by the name of the mother. And the daughter was also known as by the name of a father. So Arjun was also called Kaunte, one born of Kunti. And Draupadi was one born of Drupad.
Yes.
So the Adityas are the children of Aditi. Okay. Now we have of the 12 Adityas that, as I had told you in my, Uttarashara Nakshatra, that there are 12 Adityas, and out of them, we have 10 of them ruling 10 Nakshatras. We have Savitur, who rules the Hasta Nakshatra. And he gives us the power through the Gayatri Mantra. Then we have Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, who is also said to be the son of Aditi. And Aditi is also said to have been born of Lord Vishnu. We'll keep that aside because it's the Vedas. We'll not go into any discussion about it. But that's the way it is. He is the preserver and pervader of the universe, of the trinity of gods, that is Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. Brahmaji is said to be the creator. Lord Vishnu is said to be the preserver and the pervader. And Mahesh, that is Shiva, is said to be the destroyer. So when you talk about God, generator, operator, and destroyer. Generator is of any power is Lord Brahma. Operator of the entire system is Lord Vishnu along with his wife Lakshmi. Okay, and the one who destroys the power, has the power of destruction, is Lord Shiva along with Parvati Devi or Durga Devi. And she also takes the rule of Kali at times. She also takes the form of Kali at times. Then we come to Indra, okay, who is the ruler of the Jeshta Nakshatra, who is the solar god of protection and dominance, Mitra, who rules Anuradha, and Varuna, the solar god of, he is the Aditya, or again solar god, who is the rain god, the one who rules over the waters in general. Katswar or Vishwakarma, Chitra, he is the ruler of Chitra Nakshatra, the deity of Chitra Nakshatra, and he is the power of creativity and craftsmanship. We move on to Pushan, another very beautiful nakshatra at that, Revati, and Pushan is again the one who shows the path to not just the animals. He loves the animals, he is the caretaker of animals, but he also takes the soul from one area to the other. Okay, helps the soul to navigate from one realm to the other. So he's an excellent navigator. Then we have Aryaman and Bhaga. So they rule the nakshatras of Purva Falguni and Uttara Falguni. These gods, Aryaman and Bhaga in specific, were interchangeable gods during the Rig Veda. Sometimes you find Aryaman as Uttara Falguni and Bhaga as Purva Falguni, and sometimes you would find the vice versa, because it's a pair of nakshatras. Basically, Aryaman, as I have been working with, is the conjugal bliss and inheritance, and is Uttara associated with Uttara Falguni, and Bhaga is associated with hospitality, nobility, and patronage. Bhaga gives you a lot. You say Bhagyodaya, something like that, rise in fortune. Bhaga has the ability to give, and give. And then son of another Aditya is, from sons of Vishwava. Okay, so these are the 10 devtas of the nakshatras that we've covered so far. Sons of Ashwini Kumars. Their father is not listed here because he was left behind to take a mortal form to rule over this planet. And the Ashwini Kumars and Yam, they are born of, Vishwavat or Markandeya. And we know who Ashwini Kumars are. They are the celestial physicians. We'll do that in detail if we have the time. And Yama, the lord of the dharma and the ancestors. So when I'm teaching in my, you know, when I'm teaching in my nakshatra courses, it's very much associated with deities, so that a lot of it goes into you. So whenever I'm talking about Punarvasu Nakshatra, Aditi comes into forefront. When I'm talking about a mother, what will come to your mind? So let me take you to a, let me take you to a place where what would come to your mind when I'm talking about a Punarvasu Nakshatra. So the first thing that comes to your mind is compassionate. You know, you would also talk about somebody. Punarvasu means repetition. So mother, she has a repetitive quality. Mother is always successful. She's the mother goddess. She's bound to be successful. I have a divine protection because she's the mother. The mother always protects the child. She's very lovable. I mean, till date, there no mother is unlovable. You know, the mother will even slap the child with a loving quality because she wants what is good for the child. And because she is all-encompassing, she is the creator, she is also has abundant creativity. She, because she's the source of energy, she you can get a person who has a strong planet in Punarvasu to work endlessly.
Lord Ram is the perfect example.
So you've given it. Forgiveness. If we're talking about Lord Ram, forgiveness. He forgave everybody in his life. And wherever he went, he was, you know, he was always protected. So, and there's a very beautiful, in the Tulsi Ramayana, there's a very beautiful shloka also. So, Vibhishan is very worried about Lord Ram and says that, how are you going to fight with, somebody who is so much better placed than you in case in terms of having the weapons and the chariot and so many things? How is it possible? So he says, don't worry. I have the kavach of my guru. And he has a lot of things. He says, that's the guru's Vipra Guru Puja, that, you know, there's no kavach or protection like the blessings that you get when you're worshipping your guru, your everything. And you know, he is abundant creativity. They lived, they made a house in the densest of the forest, according to the Vastu. If you've read the Ramayana, you would be knowing that according to the Vastu principles, got the house, the ceremony done for the house. And they did it out of what? Out of something that was in the forest. And technology was not that what we had. I mean, they had to undergo a lot of hardships. Highly accomplished, such people. Because she's the Devi. She knows how to create. Another one person I'd give you an example of having a planet in Punarvasu is our Queen Victoria, the present reigning Queen Victoria.
Oh.
And even at this age of 93, she's running about doing so many things. And she's still known to have taken time out for her grandchildren, great-grandchildren. So you can see the attributes happening there. Now, this is another, devta that I would like. Another nakshatra devta is like Ashlesha. So Ashlesha, in Ashlesha, you have the Nagas as the devatas. They are sensual. They're manipulative. They have hypnotic gaze. They're highly intelligent. They might have rivalry within their own family. They're prone to gossip. And they keep a good tab on gossip. They have hereditary issues. You know, Marilyn Monroe had a planet there. And her mother was prone to drinking. Her grandmother was prone to drinking and drug abuse. And she also had that issue.
Yeah, I also have a friend. He comes and tells me, he used to tell me once upon a time that, oh, I'm the most famous person in this college or school because whatever happens, I'm the first one to be known because of that. Then I said, yes, obviously, because you are the topmost of the gossip mongers. So you are the first who will be known, obviously, for that.
And he has any planet in Ashlesha?
Yeah. That's why I gave his example.
So he has beautiful things
in this place.
So you want to show off power and ego. So he'd come and boast to you about knowing things. Need to acknowledgement of their status. So time and again, they need somebody to, so they suffer probably from a low self-esteem. They need somebody to acknowledge their status.
Yeah. Another thing I have seen, if somebody has this one with Jyeshtha Nakshatra very prominent, both together, then I have seen it time and again that if they are in a group project or in a team, they will somehow say that, oh, it was me who did all the work. They didn't do anything. It was I who did. And then...
So they are shape-shifting. They have the ability to change according to the situation.
Yes.
Today on your side, if it is not good today, they'll move to the other side. Hidden agenda. You have to be very careful about their hidden agenda. They are deadly. We all know that about snakes, don't we?
Yeah. And they are so envious that even if you don't do anything to them, you are just walking beside them, they will still come and hit you.
No, but they make bad enemies, very deadly enemies, if they are poked.
Okay.
But they can be very jealous. That you can see it from their eyes. They can be very manipulative.
Typical snake traits all.
Exactly. So you can understand what that person is going to show. Now I'll tell you. Yeah, I use this chart quite often.
Chart sitting in Germany.
I use this chart quite often. Because what makes a person tick? See, he has Saturn in his 10th house. Saturn is the fourth lord of home and family. Okay, security. And it's the fifth lord of power, authority, position. Saturn is seeing in Ashlesha, sitting in Ashlesha, and it is aspecting the 12th house of death, exit. Fourth house is family, fourth house is also race. So this man, see, if I talk about, I can also use another nakshatra of his, that is Ashwini. Okay, he has his Mars, I think. Yeah, not Mars, sorry. He has Mercury and Sun in Ashwini.
Yeah, and he has Bharani also, very strong. Where will that go?
Yeah, so Venus in Bharani, that's again in the 7th house of open enemies. So you will see Bharani is Yama. Yama, okay. And then Mars is in Prithika, Agni, which is transformation. He transformed the world after World War II. It was not the same place to live.
And his chart is the most easiest chart I have seen. In fact, they say that in Parampara, you should start from Lord Ram's chart. But sometimes I feel Lord Ram is number one, this person is number two, because this is the easiest chart to learn.
Yes, it's so evident. Things are so evident. See, Ashlesha Nakshatra, the very quietly he started off with his agenda, with just one book. And then look at his eyes. They're so hypnotic. They can hold on to the gaze. It looks as if he's reading your mind.
And when he used to speak, so many people would listen and everybody would think, oh yes, we will have the new world one day. My God.
And that's, again, it's aspecting the fourth house of masses.
The ruler itself.
Yes, and being a ruler, so it's such a strong place to be.
And because it's fifth lord also, that shows he will get position through this.
Yes, so he's got that. And it's the Ashlesha Nakshatra. Quiet, a hidden agenda, a hidden agenda. He must have had an agenda to create the world war to such a level.
And if you go back to the previous slide once. Yeah, it was written something, rivalry with own family members or something. And he had to change his country. Then he got all this.
If I'm not mistaken, he went to Austria also.
Yeah, he was born in Austria, if I'm not wrong. And then later on, he came to Germany. I'm not very sure. But it was not his own country. That's what I know.
Deadly. Quiet. He was a good observer. He didn't talk much. So when I'm talking about, then let's go back to the Devatas. So we've got Yama also, Bharani. We just saw Ashwini Kumar, his Mercury and Sun were sitting in Ashwini Nakshatra. They are one of the fastest, swiftest of all. And the way he annihilated the earth, nothing. 2 crore people in matter of 6 to 10 years gone forever from the face of this planet. 2 million people, 2 million people. No, I think it's around 6 million Jews from
Jews
the face of yeah, that is known, from the face of this planet in 6 to 10 years. What I mean,
he's Yamaraj personified.
Yes, he has his Venus, the Lagna Lord, yeah, and the eighth lord of change, death, transformation, sitting right there in the seventh house of open enemies in Bharani Nakshatra.
Because it's Lagna Lord, that shows whoever tells, I mean, historians sometimes say that, oh, there were people who instigated him, people motivated him to do this. I'm like, no, it's the Lagna Lord is he himself has decided to do this. Nobody told him.
Yes, and he was motivated by his family history. If you read carefully his family history, it's stated that it is a possibility that his grandmother, his father was born of a liaison between his grandmother and the male of the family she used to work for, and that family had a Jewish background.
Oh.
So he developed a very strong view about them because of the impoverishment that they had felt and everything. So it's a house of open enemies. Venus, the Lagna Lord, is sitting with Sun, again the 11th Lord of spouse and family, and Mercury, the 9th Lord of father. So many things, if you're reading a chart, you get the background so beautifully, and the nakshatras absolutely open up for you. Now, I'll give you a secret here. What you need to do is every day, whichever is the nakshatra, if you pray to that deity, they will open up to you. And I teach all this in my nakshatra class. I teach all this in my nakshatra class. Okay. So, We've covered all these Devatas, and then we move on to the 11 Rudras. Of the 11 Rudras, the 5 are very prominent because they hold sway over the Nakshatra's Rudra. Adra Nakshatra ruler is Rudra, and he's the god of thunder and howls and storms. You know, when Sun moves into the Adra Nakshatra, it's called Adra Pravesh. So that very day, you draw up a chart and you know how the rains are going to be like.
Oh, okay.
And once Sun has moved into Adra Pravesh, has done the Adra Pravesh, that is moved into the Adra Nakshatra, you cannot and you should not eat mangoes. You should give up on eating mangoes. They say that it is from that time that, you know, insects, the small worms, find houses in that. And I have seen it. I have seen it to my own. And at that time, I did not know about it. I had not read about this concept of Adra Pravesha. And any mango I would slice for 3 continuous years after Adra Pravesha happened for Sun, I would always find some, worm or other, the other. And then I read it and I could correlate that, yes, this is the time, you know, around 14th, so around 25th it moves around 6 to 7 degrees. Sun moves around 7 degrees in before when after it has traveled into the sign of Gemini, 6 degrees 40 minutes.
Yes.
So after 7-8 days after it moves into Gemini, when Andhra Pradesh happens, stop eating mangoes, at least Indians.
It has already happened, I think.
Today's
23rd.
Yeah. So it should have happened. It's 9 days past. But I'm just saying that it should. That's the way it is. And you can see that. And so he is, Rudra is the howling god of thunder and storms. He brings in the storms, the rain. But there's so much more to Rudra. If you just check, we'll just check the it again. Ajay Ekpada, who's the ruler of Purva Bhadrapada. Again, a very strong deity. Lasting effects. Ahirbuddhanya, who rules the Uttara Bhadrapada and the lord of fertility and the Kundalini. And then you have Niruti, who is Mula Nakshatra god. So again, people are afraid of Mula Nakshatra. But until and unless there is a destruction, there is no, you know, generation. Can you imagine if you are not going to leave this planet, what the state of this planet is going to be?
Yes, this everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody wants to die.
No, people are, because once you have all your organs stop functioning, you know, then you want to die. But you should have I believe in a dignified death, but that's a different issue. And we have the Sarpas and the Nagas, again, a very, as by depicted by Aslesha. Well, because the Sarpas are very much associated with Lord Vishnu. And also with Lord Shiva, you know, but Sarpas and the Nagas, they are inclusive of the 11 Rudras. And the Ashtavasus, the elemental gods, they are elemental gods. And they also rule over the directions. Together in one form, they rule over Dhanishta, Soma, which is a Mrigasira. Soma, another elemental god, Soma, rules over Mrigasira, and it is a name given to the moon god.
Yes.
Then we have Swati Nakshatra, Vayu. We will do that. We will do the Swati Nakshatra in the coming week. But Swati Nakshatra is ruled by Vayu. And then we have Vayu. We have Purva Shara ruled by Ahpa. We have Krit Agni, again a directional god, ruling Kritika Nakshatra. And we have Vishakha ruled by Indragni, the pair of them. So, this is the five, you know, these are the five Rudras. Then we move on to the Ashtavasus. The sixth of the eight, six of them hold the rulership over certain nakshatras. Now we move on to the nakshatra deities, which are left of the remaining 27. One is the Vishwadevatas. Collectively, these devatas, we've done it, explored this in detail in the Uttarashara section. Then we have the Prajapati, Rohini, that is the creator, Brahma, Prajapati Brahma. And then we have the preceptors of the devatas. That is, when we did the Pushya Nakshatra, we knew about Brihaspati. And finally, in the Prithvi, we have the Maghas. Okay. And then, let's take a quick look for a few of them, because we've covered quite a bit, you know, in a very short time. And this is not even the tip of the iceberg, honestly speaking. When we go deep into the deities, it's so easy to be able to delineate beyond what can be explained here. You would have to know it yourself, you know. You have to taste it yourself to say that. And they're swift. They are swift. They have a very beautiful sense. Their senses are very strong. They rescue people in distress. They're healers. They were born out of the swas or the breath of Sanjana, their mother and sun god. So they are also called Ashwini. So they relate to pranic healing also. They're the healers. They're the natural healers, natural physicians, celestial physicians. So they will know a lot of secrets. Surgeons, they make good surgeons. They travel in a chariot which is made of gold. So they're fond of vehicles. And they're very independent. They're always, they're very jovial and lovable. So if you have a, I also will have a story about, you know, this lady and Rishi Chayavan. Okay. So Rishi Chayavan was very old when he, due to certain circumstances, he married his wife in such a circumstances that she chose to, you know, work with him or live with him, because she had hurt him in such a manner that his eyes were no longer there when he was doing meditation. Now he was an old man and he wanted to also give her the comforts of life, but he was old and infirm and had lost his eyesight, so he could not help her. But Ashwini Kumar's see that beautiful lady, Sukanya, and they come to her rescue. And they say that you marry us. And she says, you know, I'm the wife of a Rishi, so I can curse you so badly. And they realize the mistake. They say, okay, fine. We will take your husband. We are the celestial doctors. We will cure your husband. But there's a disclaimer attached. What is the disclaimer? The disclaimer is, you have to recognize your husband when he comes out of the pool. And whoever you say is your husband becomes your husband. So either of the twin or her husband, and because they would give their form to her husband. So she says, ki, not to worry, chalo, you take him. So then they give him a dip and they cure him. He comes out as a very strong, handsome young man, as handsome as they are. Okay, in the here it's shown as a figurehead of a horse, but they're very beautiful to look at. So he's also very handsome. Now what she does is she holds her hand in total grace and says, Ashwini Kumars, I beseech you to help me recognize my husband. And because they're the gods, they're celestial beings, they're celestial devtas, they understand, they know the prayer has reached them and they're very pleased with her. And they give, they come to their own form and give her husband a different form of a youth, of a good man, firm, young, handsome. And they help the ladies in distress. So many, if you know the stories behind them, if you know the nature, basic nature of a, you know, a lord or a devta, you would be able to find out so many attributes.
Yeah, and I have also seen this playing. I have seen, especially whenever moon transits Rohini, this I have seen in my personal experience. If I go to a gathering, there will be one lady who will look totally distinct from all the other ladies sitting. I have seen this so many times. Or you go there, you will see a lady who is wearing totally a red dress, you will see, because both red and that distinctive thing is related to Rohini.
Right.
And I have seen this in last 2 months. I have gone to some programs and that day moon was in Rohini. I'm like, bang.
So it makes you more observant. And yeah, she will draw many eyes. That lady will draw many eyes.
Yeah, everybody will be looking to her.
Yeah. So now let's take up of Rudra. Okay. Anger. You know, when you say in Hindi, you say Rudra Roop. That means you are in your full anger mode. So an anger is associated with Lord Shiva here, the Rudra Roop of his. Compassionate, very, very compassionate, very easy to please. One of his name is also Ashutosh. He's very easy to please. What does he want? You know, what does he want? He wants something that none ever take. There's, I do not know what they call Dhatura in English. I do not know what it is called. Okay. And then they, in fact, I forget, because we do work on that. And then the Bel Patri, you know, that is, no, it's not betel leaf. It's a very triangular, very It's a very, just a second, I'll tell you. Or I'll post it there. If anybody asks this, I'll post it there. You know, so this leaf is all that he asks. He's given after the offerings, what is left as the husk of the offerings he takes, and he's happy with that. And where does he live? He lives in the Shamshan. He lives in very quiet places. He's unafraid, totally unafraid. And he lives in places that nobody wants to go. He has very strong emotions of like, dislike, everything. He could have marital issues. You know, Shiva faced a lot of marital issues due to his in-laws. So this person can have a lot of issues due to their in-laws. This person would be a technocrat. Shiva loves the animals. He always has a pack of dogs following him. And I've seen, you know, this. There's this... I had this Russian lady, highly intelligent Russian lady, who had many PhDs to her post, you know. And during a class, she was just asking. So I said, she had a Mercury retrograde. Retrograde Mercury is absolutely, which is also combust. So that is an extremely sharp mind, a very discerning mind, and a mind which will pinpoint things, but very, very critical. So I said, did you have any problem with animals ever, or did you do anything for animals? And she said that I was one of those people who actually fought for the elephants. Oh. And there was a campaign going on, and she said that I have this PhDs to my name. But, you know, and there is occult associated with this. Addictions. You see, the chillum or the ganja or the weed that Shiva smokes. He's battle hardened, forever fighting battles. Lord Vishnu doesn't fight battles. You see Lord Shiva and his family, especially Kartikeya, running towards the battlefield. Lord Rudra had to fight for his place in the society. So these people are generally struggling to find a place, have a lot of struggle to find a place. They will always have a difference of opinion with their father because of the stories associated with it. And they will always create a new path. Now let me take you on to one of my very strong examples of a Rahu ruled and a Shiva ruled planet, which is Shah Rukh Khan. So Shah Rukh Khan has his Jupiter right here. So many things that I tabulated, he's known to be a very angry person. You know, he gets into fights with so many people on the go, and he creates a bad name for himself. He is very generous. We do not know the amount of money he donates to people on account of hospitals or, you know, charities. So many things he does. He has very strong, you know, small children coming up to him and talking to him. He's one of the most compassionate men. And he has very strong sense of like and dislike. Just the other day I was watching, you know, again, Jupiter represents children. And he has a daughter whom he's very possessive about. So he has very strong sense of what she should do and what she shouldn't do. And that was something that was going on there. Addictions. He is a chain smoker. He's a path breaker. You know, nobody in his family has moved into this acting and come to such a stellar position. He started with theater and so many things. So this is just one nakshatra. When I take up the entire thing, it will give me such a beautiful picture. And just for because I'm also doing something on, because you are really very interested in Swati Nakshatra, he has his ascendant in Swati Nakshatra.
Oh.
He also has his sun in Swati Nakshatra.
And today moon is also in Swati.
Yes, and he also has a Saturn in, Satabihisha.
And Jupiter has just entered Swati.
So he has a Saturn in Satavisha, which is such a beautiful nakshatra. Again, an all Rahu ruled nakshatra, and his Rahu is in Rohini, which is, as you just said, prosperous, color red. He's wearing a red here. I didn't even recognize that, notice it, but yes, color red. Always growing. His growth has been exponential. He's known to be one of the highest paid actors of, and he has his hands in so many pies. Financially, he's gained such lot. So, if we just know the nakshatras, if we just know the deities as associated with the, Indian systems, we would actually be able to go far, far ways. So far, you have no clue what the deity, I can just have a 4 hour, we've been talking for nearly close to 1.5 hours. And I've still so much to say. The Pitris, they're compassionate. We've done the Pitris as one of the 27 Devtas. They are the ancestors. So the ancestors are responsible for us. Okay. They are very idealistic in their approach. They are very strong authorities in their own fields. They are wealthy also. And they're very spiritual. And the Pitris, if they come in your dreams, they will guide you. Many people have problems in the families because they do not offer anything to the Pitris. They forget their ancestors. So their DNA gets more and more coiled with that of the ancestors.
Oh, okay.
If you remember them, your DNA moves away. You are able to release them, and so your DNA will also be released of certain properties.
Yeah, and I have also asked many senior astrologers regarding this. They had said that if your sun and moon are eclipsed, either of them, or your fifth house and ninth house has serious afflictions, or their lords are very severely afflicted, then you need to do something with Pitris.
Exactly. Jean Perry, he was an astounding man. He has got 3 in nakshatras. In the nakshatra, 3 planets in the nakshatra of Magha. He was an astounding man who did so much for education of children. He socially felt responsible. He said that education is the only way to eradicate violence, physical, mental, any which. And he worked so hard to get things on the platform that one of the education systems was known after him. He was a Frenchman, very well known. Okay, so we have so many, I could go on, and we could just be talking on that, not just the nakshatra devtas, devtas of the tithis, devtas of the varas, yoga, karna, planets, everything. The devtas hold a very strong key, and they will give you so much to know about in astrology, because again, at the end of this session, I will only repeat that astrology is known to be part of the Vedas for a very strong reason. It's supposed to be for your upliftment. And the powers that are bestowed by these Devatas to you, or the powers that they resonate in your chart, is something for you to look into. Once you know about these Devatas, once you know about the qualities, stellar qualities that they have, also of their, the vices, if there is, then you can modulate your lifestyle, you can move on to a different level, and you can become a happier and a more spiritually oriented person.
And then you can ask, when is the day I'm going to get married or a new job?
Then you wouldn't need to ask, you would know.
Yeah, yes. Because I have seen with the number of consultations that I have done in past 1 or 2 years that sometimes there are very less number of people who actually know what they want to do in life. So for us, it becomes quite, it's like a dialogue where we understand, okay, you want this, 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 then the chart is saying this, then you can go this side. But if the person comes and tells you, I don't know anything what to do in life, my Venus is in 10th house, will I become an actor? You can't say that. There is no other astrologer who can also say that. I mean, millions of people will have Venus in the 10th, but that doesn't mean you become an actor. Only with that placement. Of course, we can go on pros and cons, but we have to understand the things in detail. Every planet, that's what I always say to people, that whenever somebody asks me that, oh, my 10th lord is here, I say, don't judge career only by the 10th lord. Just, you have to see the whole chart. Where is the flow? You have to know these deities and these nakshatras. What are their stories? Then you see where is it resonating. Like I gave you the example of Jyeshtha and Ashlesha combined. That has a different flow. Now, if that so is combined with...
Indra. So Indra wants competition, right? Yeah. But he wants authority. He is a dictator.
Yes.
These people will not do much work. The Jyeshtha and Ashlesha, they will not do, they will guide, but they will want all the, the praise for themselves.
And I have also seen in my own personal research that if suppose you are in a team and there's a person who has a very prominent Jyeshtha and a very prominent Pushya, both, then if you can mix both of them and then the Pushya person will guide this person, then the team energy is very harmonious because Brihaspati and Indra are together. It's like... Nobody
yes.
can defeat
and
them.
Brihaspati is the guiding factor. Brihaspati is the guru. So if you can get the Brihaspati person, the Indra person will be born, bound to agree.
Yeah.
Or follow.
Yeah, and these Jyeshtha people I have seen sometimes that if they feel that the person who is guiding them cannot actually guide them, he's just beating around the bush, as in Asmi's you say na sale bara kubua. Just saying this, that, but actually the person doesn't know how to guide, then they will say, oh no, I'm not going to stay in this company or I will not take you as my guide.
Yes, they're very clear cut.
Yes.
Don't want. Leave.
Yeah, so these information, these stories and these, I mean, the other day somebody was telling me, oh, what's the use of segregating individual Puranic stories from this scripture, that scripture and connect them to astrology? You know, it's not of much use. And then I was like, then why do you need astrology after all? No? If that
yes.
is not required. So it's very
you
wonderful.
Pass on the link of this video to that friend of yours or whoever. Or she was.
It was a comment. I read it around 3 to 4 months back, but I remembered it. I mean, so much information is there, and amazing it is. Thank you very much. And whoever is interested to join your course, maybe they can go and register in the link. I'll give it in the description. It's starting tomorrow. Fantastic.
Thank you so much, Babaji, for this platform.
And I'm very sure
this is wonderful teaching experience also, because this is one subject which is very close to my heart, that is the Devtas.
Yes. And today is the famous Pandav Nirjal Ekadashi also, and I hope whoever is watching this video is blessed and they are also inspired to learn on the deities and the nakshatras. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Yes, we'll see you next time with Swati.